Jai Sachidanand. I bow to pure soul within you, everybody. Jai Sachidanand. This is spiritual science. This is not a religion. There is no rituals in this spiritual science. This is pure understanding and basic thing, fundamental thing we have to know in this world. Who am I? Because due to self-ignorance, we are suffering so much pain, so much worries, so much stress, insult, everything. Why we are suffering in this world? Because of our self-ignorance. Once we realize who am I, then all worries and stress will go away and we will get inner bliss. And Dada Bhagwan, to whom we say as Dada Bhagwan, his so many life he was searching about what is reality, what is universal truth. In this life he got the spiritual knowledge in 1958. Who is the doer? Who is governing this whole universe? What is pure soul? What is God? Why the karma is getting charged? How to get salvation? Everything he got within 1 hour at that time, 1958. He also says that at that time when I got this knowledge, 48 minutes it remained, and I visualized whole universe. I saw, I experienced what is universal truth. And if my ego, anger, greed, everything gone. I separated from my mind, speech and body, and myself, total separation take place. And from that time, he says, I have no worry, no stress, complete peace all the time. So, due to that spiritual understanding, he was, from childhood, he was searching what is reality all the time, and final stage of realization is got in 1958. And that science we can say is a Akram Vignan. Akram means stepless path for achievement of self-realization. There are two type of path in this world. One is step by step, step by step, step by step. We have to do something to achieve self-realization. Doing some meditation, some worship, some chanting some mantra or some penance or some leaving our home, wife, everything. And doing sadhana or for our finding out who am I. But some spiritual, means not a spiritual, but in religion they are teaching, do something, chant some mantra, do meditation, do worship, and you will get finally self-realization. But that is a long, long, long path. So many years and so many life we have spent for in that path. Still we have not achieved our self-realization. It is possible in that path also, in presence of Tirthankar like Lord Mahavir or say Lord Krishna, in presence of such a enlightened person, we can terminate our journey for our self-realization. But in this time, no such Tirthankar, no such Jnani is available. But due to our merit karma, Dada Bhagwan in this time, he got such a spiritual knowledge, and this is not step by step path. It is stepless path, or say elevator lift, elevator path. within 2 hours we can get our realization. Within 1 hour, exactly 48 minutes, we are getting realization of self. And next 1 hour, we are getting 5 principles, how to remain in pure soul and how to dissolve our discharge karma. So there should not be any new karma charge, and there, all our discharge karma of past life, we can finish without charging new karma, in remaining in our awareness of pure soul. So within 2 hours we are getting this knowledge, who am I, who is the doer. Here no rituals is there, only we have to understand. That's why our satsang session is mostly question and answer, because up to today in our religion life we must have done something. So we must know what is correct. If it is correct, then we should continue that things, and if it is not correct, we will have to leave that things and get the correct things. So here we are allow you to ask questions and get answer about what is universal truth, what is goal of life, how to achieve that, what is soul, what is how to stop charging new karma. Everything you can ask, you can get what is Dada's vision about reality. 2 fundamental things you will get here, and that is actually our goal of life. 1, who am I? Really, who am I? We must know. Because whatever name given to our body, we are believing, I am that name. I am Alicia. But it is name given to the body. But really, you are Alicia, or your name is Alicia. So we don't know, it is any contradiction between 2 sentences. And whole worldly people, they know, I am Alicia is correct, my name is Alicia also correct. But what is correct, we don't know. In the spiritual science, we are knowing that Alicia is the name given to the body for identification. And you are owner of the name. So who are you? Who am I? That really we don't know. And that's why whatever problem comes to Alicia, you feel it is with me, I have to suffer for these problems. Once you detach from Alicia and once you know who am I, the whole problem get dissolved and you will have permanent happiness. So this is basic fundamental thing, we must know who am I. At the same time, another part of this spiritual knowledge is who is governing all this universe, who is the real doer behind all this happening. It is also very important to know who is the real doer, because we are believing I am doer, I am doing so and so, I have done my business, I am running my family, everything. But really, who is the doer? That is also biggest question in spirituality. And Dada Bhagwan, he was also searching so many life, who is real doer? Somebody says God is doer, somebody says karma are doer, our luck is doer, but who is really doer? And finally, in 1958, when he realized that spiritual knowledge, at that time he got who is the real doer. In our satsang, spiritual discourses, you will get that explanation, who is real doer. So 2 fundamental things here we will explain you. Because of doership, we have all these worries, stress, tensions. Once you know who is real doer, automatically your worry will stop. Due to doership, we are charging new karma. Once your doership goes away, you know who is the real doer, automatically our doership automatically it falls down, and we can have remain in our experience of pure soul. So 2 fundamental things you will get here. What is our ultimate goal of life? to achieve salvation or liberation. But ultimate liberation is the last stage. But we should get something in our day-to-day life so that we should not have any misery, sufferings, stress, worries. So first stage of liberation in this life, day-to-day life, and this knowledge you will get here is first stage of salvation, stopping our new charging karma and inner happiness, permanent happiness. Whatever you are getting happiness is only temporary happiness, and it ends to gives to us again unhappiness. So we want to come out from all worldly unhappiness and happiness and get permanent happiness by this spiritual knowledge. So this is basic things, and this spiritual science is vast. You can ask some questions, then you will get more answer about this spiritual science. So anybody want to ask some question, you can. We'll continue our satsang by question and answers.
It seems that sometimes through, as karma is discharging, that it's more difficult than at other times to stay separate. Sometimes who am I is very clear, and based on the magnitude of what is discharging, it's very obvious that I'm not foul one. And then when, I guess you could call it heavier discharge, things that are real core to foul one's prakriti are discharging, it's much more difficult to stay in the seat of pure soul. So could you elaborate on that, please?
Yeah. See, this is knowledge, spiritual knowledge or knowledge of self-realization. It is given to you. You have not dissolved your karma and getting this knowledge. So really, it is a, by grace you are getting this spiritual knowledge. Your discharged karma remain pending, and all, we have bypassed all discharged karma and given you the spiritual knowledge. In kramik mark, that step-by-step path, they are dissolving all discharged karma, anger, greed, lust and everything, and slowly they achieve realization of soul. So they don't have force of discharge karma. And in this our akram path, stepless path, our discharge karma has tremendous force. And in the beginning, when you got this jnana, all karma, you feel experience of soul immediately. And if you start practicing five principles, then slowly, because anger, greed, everything is pride, everything is not dissolved. It is still there. Slowly, when you come in your day-to-day life, they will come out. So at that time, you have to practice five principles and dissolve that anger, greed, pride, lust, everything. So after some times, every day you have to practice this. Somebody may hurt by Jeff, you have to keep separation from Jeff, and discharge karma is with Jeff. Jeff may hurt anybody, then you have to ask Jeff to do pratikaman. Slowly, discharge karma also dissolves. Force of discharge karma will be less and less and less. So your awareness remain continuous now. So it will take time, but see, your belief has totally changed. So when discharge karma has force, so your awareness will go away. Still your belief doesn't change, it remains constant. So what happens? Your discharge karma starts, say, from 0 degree to, say, 90 degree. And it will slowly dissolve up to 80, 70, 60, 40, 20, and 0. Your awareness is there. So at the time of your awareness is only 15 degree. So at that time when comes that discharge, karma gets force is less and it will dissolve, it will decrease up to say, 0 level. At that time your awareness comes again. At that time you are separating chaff and yourself. At that time you are practicing five principles. Whatever happens is result of scientific circumstantial evidence. It is relative, it is file. I have to dissolve it by equanimity. So slowly, slowly, slowly your awareness, you are increasing. So this is process, dissolving discharge karma and getting more awareness. So it will take time. But your belief is 100% change. I am pure soul, I am not doer, scientific circumstantial evidence are the doer. That's why you are not charging new karma. But discharge karma, you have to dissolve, it will take time. And when you apply five principles, at that time only your discharge karma will dissolve, it will vanish, and your awareness will increase. This is process. We have to go through this process. And one more thing, any discharge karma having a heavily force, you can be in touch with us, ask your problem and get solution with spiritual knowledge. So that will help you in practicing five principles as well as solving our discharge karma.
I would like to ask about the role of the mind in this process. In my own experience, it seems to me that opposed to earlier in my life, before I had Gyanvidhi, I used to try to do things very much from the mind. And whenever I fall back into that habit, like trying to apply the five principles, if I'm even trying to apply them, it's already a mental battle and it's not real. Whereas the real process for me seems to be that I just remember the five principles, but it's not really in thought. It's just, it's a higher intuitive sense that this is, the five principles basically are the nature of my soul and how the soul views the world and interaction in life. And I found that for the most part, thoughts don't really contribute anything or they don't add anything to my spiritual process. So when you say practicing the five principles, and especially practicing the five principles in times of discharge karma or when sticky files come up and so on which level does this ideally happen? How to apply the five principles so it's actually real and it's not another practice we are trying to do, like so many of us try to do practices?
I have two questions. Role of mind in the spiritual path. First, I will give you answer for that. See, in this, there are two paths. Kramik means step-by-step path. In that path, the mind role is totally different. They are believing that mind is disturbing for our spiritual progress. But in this path, and they are controlling mind, they want to stabilize mind, they want to make a stable mind in that path. And they are doing meditation for that, stopping mind wandering here and there in that path. And in this path, you are separated from Christian. And Christian has mind, speech, body, intellect, ego, chit, everything. So you are totally separated from Christian. Now mind is a object and you are observer. Mind is a just like a film on in theater. You are watching film. So whatever film is going on, you are watching. So you are observer and that is object. Here also mind is object and you are observer. Now how to deal with mind? And Dada has given such a technical knowledge, spiritual knowledge. You have to do conversation with, say, Christian or say, with mind. mind shows two type of thoughts. See, there are four part inner action taking place. See, body, whatever doing is an outer action. And there are four part inner action: mind, intellect, ego, and chit. The chit means, it is not in Western word any other word for that, but we can say chit. Chit means visualization, something, photography. Its function is to show some photography. While mind has function only thoughts, positive or negative, but it shows only thoughts, good or bad thoughts. While intellect, it takes two things. It takes decision, as well as it always shows some profit and loss, good and bad. While ego is not doing anything, he is just like a president in parliament. Intellect is a prime minister, and mind and chit, they are giving votes. So voter, this intellect is a prime minister, and ego is a president. This is like parliamentary system. They are giving voting, what to do. Then intellect will decide, this is final. Intellect will find out what is profit, how it is profitable. Then intellect will decide, this is correct. At that time, ego will sign, yes, this is correct, go ahead. Once inner action completed, your body will start outer action. So in our akram path, we have to just watch what is happened with Christian. So when bad thoughts are coming, you have to just do conversation with Christian or say mind, and keep separation from bad or good thoughts. You are really observer. Once you become knower and seer of thoughts, automatically thoughts will dissolve. It will not harmful to you. When it is harmful to us, if we are involving in that thoughts, then only it will troubleful to us. If we are separated and if we are just knowing or say only observing, know and see, then it will automatically get discharged. So this part is completed. Now your another question.
Well, the other question was, for example, the practice of the five principles.
Yeah.
In my experience, simply staying in the soul seems to include also the five principles automatically.
Correct.
And sometimes I get into this old habit, I need to practice something. And then it seems to just go to the mind, and the mind trying to be a good little boy and trying to do it right, and it just doesn't work. So the question was, is it enough to simply stay in the soul? It seems to me that that is also including the five principles.
Yeah, ultimate, why we have to practice five principles? Once you practice, automatically we'll come to, you are coming in soul. But we have so many files. We have so much discharge karma. And our mind has so many tumors or knots. Anger, sex, say good and bad thoughts, pride, all things inside that mind. So we have to dissolve that mind, or say, and Christian is a file number one. His wife, children, or say some job or business. So many files we are having. So in that file, if we practice five principles, then only you can remain in pure soul. Whenever some business, if you say this is my file, then you will be in pure soul. If you say I am doer, then you will be involved in Christian. If you say scientific, circumstantial evidence are the doer, so automatically you will be in pure soul. It is with Christian, not with me. Then also, if you keep separation between relative and real, then again you are coming in pure soul. So by practicing only, you can come to pure soul. So what you can do, we have force of discharge karma will be there. sticky file are also there. So what we can do, we have to decide in the morning, I want to remain in five principles. Just think how to remain in five principles. I want to separate, I want to keep separation between relative and real. I want to see everybody as a pure soul and their relative part, packing and soul separate. Whatever happens is result of scientific circumstantial evidence. Whatever comes in front of me, it is file for me. I don't want to make any hatred or attachment or abhorrence to that file. So slowly you have to decide, I want to practice five principles such way for whole day, and try to practice at the time of file comes in front of you. Keep separation, ask Christian to solve this file. And before sleep, just for 10 to 15 minutes, take whole action replay or whole review of whole day. What happens, where I missed my five principles. And try to reset five principles again. Slowly, slowly, your practice will be more and more, your understanding will be clear for solving files, for practicing five principles. So your awareness goes on increasing. So this is only way, if we practice our awareness, and slowly when awareness of our pure soul increase, we'll have more and more experience of pure soul. So that will remain constant forever. So our discharge karma dissolves at the time we have experience of our pure soul. So by practicing only, you can remain in pure soul. It will take time, but beginning already started. Now by practicing, we will get more and more awareness, more and more experience of pure soul. While practicing five principles, we are not using mind or intellect. We are using direct light of pure soul. It is called Prajna Shakti. So Prajna Shakti, power of pure soul, direct light of pure soul. And it takes decision, I want to remain in five principles. It is not through mind, not through intellect. And mind and intellect, it is discharge karma. And Prajna Shakti, it directly helps for practicing five principles. So whenever you are deciding, I want to remain in five principles, it is not through mind, it is through Prajna Shakti. So when you are deciding, it will help you more and more. Awareness will be more and more about pure soul. And if you want, I can remain in pure soul, but it is not possible because of discharge karma. So many files. So you have to clear all files, then only by practicing five principles, you will clear all files, then only you can remain continuous in your pure soul. So it will take time.
So who is actually the one who makes this decision to stay in pure soul?
Prajna Shakti. Prajna means direct light of pure soul. When, what's your name?
Osnat.
Osnat. When we have belief that I am Osnat, so it is, you are really Osnat, or your name is Osnat?
It's just my name.
Yeah, and still you say, I am Osnat. So what is correct?
That's just a language way of speaking.
Yeah, so who are you?
That's my question.
You are, so this is ignorance for ourselves, who am I? So due to that ignorance, we have wrong belief, I am Osnat, I am wife of so-and-so, I am mother of so-and-so, I am daughter, I am sister. So due to that wrong belief, we have generated ego, intellect, everything. And it works while in our day-to-day life, due to ignorance. When you realize who am I, it is called right belief. Osnat is separate and I am pure soul. Once you get right belief, at that time, charged ego gets dissolved, and Prajna Shakti, direct light of pure soul, starts. And that direct light helps you to remain in pure soul, separation from mind, speech and body, dissolve our discharge karma. So Prajna Shakti take over whole control.
Thank you.
Each of us has discharge karma that needs to be dissolved. And my question is, what is the nature of collective karma? How does that affect us? And as we discharge individual karma, as it's dissolved, does that affect the collective karma?
Actually, individual karma, whatever collective karma is, once you, in present time, in present tense, individual karma is coming. If we say collective karma, but really it is individual karma for you. So in present time, individual karma comes and you have to keep separation from them karma, practice five principles, that will dissolve. So collective, from collective part, individual is coming. And slowly it will get dissolved by practicing five principles. In collective, still it is coming individually. Suppose this whole something happened here now. It is collective for everybody. But still you have feel individually. So for discussing, we can say it is collective karma for everybody. But for you, it is individually. You have some fear or you have some attention. Whatever happened with, what's your name?
Richard.
Richard. So whatever happened with Richard, you have to observe what happened to Richard. So you have to suffer individually only. And at that time, if you keep awareness, then that discharge karma will go away, dissolves.
What that says to me is that if we take care of what's happening here, that's the best way we can help.
Yeah.
Everyone.
First, you have to clear file number one. But file number two, say, when comes, so at that time, you are clearing file number two. But really, you are dissolving inside your attachment or say, any pride or say, bad negativity or positivity. So you are clearing file number one at a time. When you are solving file number two, at the same time, you are dissolving your file number one also. But if you attend only file number one, so your attention is only on file number one, then file number two, three, four, everything remain pending. So this is our file, but we will solve last, finally. Initially, in this primary stage, we have to solve file number two. What is her mind? What is problem with her? Say, any expectations or any attachment or any bad or good opinions, anything. So we have to solve file number two, say, three, or anything comes in front of us. And there is no file, then we have to solve our file number one. So make two departments, file number one and file and other file number. Whenever other file comes, you solve that files. If there is no other file, then you find out in file number one, what is, when somebody insult you, what happens? Somebody gives you some love, what happens? Somebody expect for you, what happens? Somebody blame on you, what happens? You clear your file number one. So two division we are making. When file comes, we have to solve other files. And there is no file, then for file number one, we have to check and solve our all that's enemies, anger, greed, everything. You understood?
Yes, thank you.
After the non-vidi, when we do the non-vidi, the pure soul is separate of the body. Okay, how is the soul is getting separate from the body?
See, how is attached with body, involved in body, due to wrong belief. So by wrong belief, you feel oneness with Claudette, or say mind, thoughts, intellect, speech, behavior. Whenever you take Claudette take decision, you feel I am taking decision. Somebody insult Claudette, you feel I have to suffer for this insult. So your belief is wrong. Due to that wrong belief, you are totally involved in clouded. Now, by Gyanvidhi, we are changing, by grace of Dada Bhagwan, your wrong belief to right belief. What is right belief? Who am I? Who is the doer? What is relative? What is real? What is scientific, circumstantial evidence? What is file? How to keep separation? So by right belief, you are separated from clouded. And this is beginning of experience of pure soul. Say 1 degree of experience, we have to reach 100 degree. So slowly, if you practice 5 principles, your awareness will go on increasing, you will get more experience of pure soul. One thing you must understand, experience of pure soul is not like that we will see some lights and some vibration and happiness and everything. That is not real experience. Experience of pure soul means you can feel separation with clouded, or more clear idea, you can see fault of clouded. Somebody may, sometimes clouded may become angry on anybody. You can watch, oh, it is with clouded. She become angry on somebody. This is wrong. So when you find out mistake of clouded, at that time you are in pure soul. And everybody you can see as an innocent, flawless vision. Nobody has done any mistake. Root cause is with clouded only. Claudette had done mistake, that's why she is suffering for that mistake. And everybody just one of the evidence for giving result of our mistake. So once you see your mistake, or say Claudette's mistake, then only you will be in pure soul. So for remaining in pure soul, we have to just observe mistakes of Claudette. File number one.
Is it a physical detach?
Physical, it is not physical detach. Really speaking, by vision of Jnani, pure soul is always separate from mind, speech and body, intellect, ego, everything. Pure soul is always separate. So really, both elements are always separate. Just like oil and water, they never mix with each other. The property of both elements such that it remains all the time immixable form. Here also pure soul and matter, they are really, both elements are total separate and they are not really mixed with each other. But by wrong belief, you feel that I am suffering, I am doing, I am feeling, I am having involved, means you remain oneness with clouded, but by wrong belief only. And belief means 4 types of wrong belief. When I am clouded, my body is, this is my body, this is my husband, so with myness, you are attaching with clouded, and you are says, I am doer, for I am making food, for everything, I am doing job, so you are doer. So again you are joining with clouded, and you are sufferer, then also you become oneness with clouded. So by right belief, you can remain separate from clouded. Whatever suffering comes, you have to understand by understanding only. Oh, it is suffering with clouded only. Whatever suffering comes, it is with clouded, not with me. Because you are really a separate from clouded. So in Jnanvidhi, you are getting this knowledge, who am I really? And slowly, if you practice, you can have more and more separation with clouded.
It's not like the pure soul is going out a little bit out of the body.
Not at all.
No. It is chit.
It is chit is going out of this body.
So chit.
Chit can move in this body also. It can go anywhere in this world. Wherever we have see something, it goes there.
The chit is not related to the pure soul?
No, it is. There are 2 types of chit, impure chit and pure chit. Pure chit, it remains in pure soul. Impure chit never remains in pure soul. It will remain in matter, phases of matter, relative things. So Now, while Jnanvidhi, your impure chit part of, means some part of impure chit has changed. And 100% it is pure now. And it will not come through from pure soul. It will remain in pure soul. But it is a stage of, say, belief only. There are three types of stage. One is right belief, one is awareness of pure soul, one is experience of pure soul. So first stage we achieved now. So it will remain in pure soul with right belief only. But by awareness, because of discharge karma, your awareness may decrease or increase. But once you practice five principles, your awareness slowly goes on increasing. Your discharge karma get dissolves. And that will give you experience of pure soul. And once you get experience of pure soul, it will remain constant. So degree of experience slowly increasing by practicing five principles and dissolving our discharge karma.
Thank you.
Jai Sachidana.
What is the reason that pure soul, the spirit, originally incarnated into the body and got attached and the wrong belief that we are the mind, the ego, the intellect, and all that? What is the origin of that?
Really speaking, soul is permanent element. No, soul is immortal or mortal? What you will say? For soul is temporary or permanent?
Soul is permanent.
Soul is permanent. So permanent thing never created, never destroys. There are six eternal elements in this world and all are permanent. So matter, whatever we can experiencing by five senses, it is matter, phases of matter. But matter is also permanent element. So in origin stage, what happened? Soul is totally covered with matter. Soul is a form of light, say. 1000 watt bulb is there. If we put some pot on that, so not a single ray of light will come out from pot. So total darkness, but inside it's full light. Still due to covering, we are not getting any rays of light coming out. So very initial stage is as per the Tirthankar or say spiritual teacher, this is first stage, soul total covering with matter. Not a single ray of coming out. After, see, there are three stage, three division in this world. One, soul total uncovered and get liberation, ultimate liberation. It is called Siddha Bhagavan or it is gone out of this universe. It gone, that ultimate liberation achieved. So that is completely uncovered soul. In this world, whatever we are observing from one sense to five sense creatures. And before that, so before that, there are so many creatures, living things, but totally covered. Not a single sense came out. So in that stage, whole soul is there. It is full light, but totally covered. Not a single sense is coming through that soul, that living thing. It is called as a nigod in our the spirituality. Mahavir Bhagwan told that it is a nigod, so total covered soul. When one soul from this world, it goes to out of universe, it is a liberated soul. At that time, one soul from nigod, it comes to this world. And this journey starts. So only little, say one hole of that covering broken, one ray of light came. And one sense creature created. Nobody has created, but it is the only scientific circumstantial evidence. Due to that scientific circumstantial evidence, one sense creation creator we can see this is a potato, tomato, grains, vegetables. Everything are one sense created, touch sense. They have touch sense. So one more soul go to liberation, one more soul will come in this world, and this one sense will go to two sense will go to three sense, like development take place. Just like Darwin theory, development, theory of development. It is correct. Up to human, whatever Darwin has mentioned, it is correct. From one sense to two sense, two sense. Two sense means first, one sense means touch sense. Then two sense means touch and taste. Three sense means touch, taste and smell. Fourth is reason. And fifth is hearing. So five sense, then slowly mind gets developed. Then in human, mind and intellect, chit, ego slowly gets developed. So this is stage of development. Slowly up to development of intellect, it reaches to such a stage, say anger or greed or pride, it reaches to 40 feet height. In a very, very, very beginning, say only 1 inch height. In some development, it is very, in human, they are also human, these are also human. And when full development of soul, what we can say, it has fully developed, means full intellect is developed, anger, greed, lust, pride, everything is full developed. At that time they feel, I don't want this worldly unhappiness, I want some inner bliss, inner happiness. And at that time it will search for happiness. And in our spiritual scripts or say all these religions or guru, they are guiding them towards spirituality. And once he get who am I, then his spiritual journey ends. Automatically he feels, who am I? Well, he has his own experience of pure soul. Oh, really, I am pure soul. I'm full of bliss, I'm full of infinite knowledge. Slowly, once he realizes himself, who am I? Then he has to discharge all karma without charging new karma. And automatically there is no charge of new karma, then there will not be new birth. So that soul will have total stage of uncovered, so absolute stage of pure soul will occur, and that soul will reach to ultimate salvation. So this is how total development takes place, from total covering on soul to total uncovered soul. Due to covering, it feels unhappiness. And when total uncover stage, it has full bliss, full happiness, permanent happiness. And that soul, when it gets to liberation, it remains in permanent happiness for infinite time. So this is how development goes on.
Thank you.
Jay Satchitanand. I have a question. It is about, I received a letter. I have a Danish Dada Bhagwan website, and I received a letter from a man who said that I should not call my website Vedanta.dk, because Simanda Swami was a Jain Tirthanga, and so he believed that this philosophy of Dada Bhagwan was a form of Jain philosophy. So my question is, what is the difference between the philosophy of Dada Bhagwan and Vedanta, if there is any?
Vedanta.
Yeah.
You see, in Vedanta, whatever explained, at that time, somebody must be Jnani was there. He has explained to everybody whatever, and all that scripture becomes Vedanta. Person is alive and he is just like Lord Krishna is giving knowledge to Arjun. So in presence of Krishna and in presence of Arjun, whatever talk taking place, at that time Lord Krishna explained to Arjuna, and Arjuna received everything what Lord Krishna explained, and he has click about his pure soul, and he remained in pure soul, so he got God salvation. Now the talk is becomes a Gita. So just like Vedanta is a talk, discussion, discourses, at that time it is correct. In this time, time and space and all factors change. That's why that is not helpful in this time. The science, Siddhanta means whatever science, it is correct. But with understanding, due to our understanding is wrong, we are not getting good result from Vedanta as well as Jainism. Because the Lord Mahavir or whatever that Rishi Muni, they have given Vedanta, it is correct, 100% correct. Aham, Brahmasmi, anger, ego, everything they have mentioned correctly. But due to our wrong belief, we are not absorbing correct things. So one living person with you, experienced person, he will explain you, if he will explain you from Vedanta, you will get correct answer, correct understanding. Or otherwise, in this time, what happens in Vedanta or any Jainism, everything it is correct. But this is total different time. Before 2500 Jainism, whatever Lord Mahavir has explained to every person, they got this knowledge and they got liberation also. But we are in this time, according to our time and space and all environment, we must get a living person should be there and he should explain according to this situation. Suppose somebody wants to come to this place. He called from Delhi, so his route will be different. Somebody wants to come from Chennai, his route should be different. So Lord Krishna has given this knowledge to Arjun. Arjun is at Delhi, and from Delhi to Simandar city, how to come, he has given. But you are not at Delhi, you are at, say, Calcutta. So from there to here, it is total different path. Like we are in Kali Yuga in this time. So Dada Bhagwan has found out how to give knowledge to these people so that they can come to pure soul. So that's why this is total different path. But really, principally, it is not different. Principally, it is correct, same thing. But way of teaching, way of giving Jnanvidhi, everything is new according to this time. So then only if by this process or by this teaching, you can understand, you can come to pure soul. You can understand how to keep separation of pure soul and everything. What are the properties? Now if you read Vedanta by this vision, by this understanding, you will see there is no contradiction. If Jainism, you feel, oh, there is no contradiction. Gita, if you read by this knowledge, by this understanding, you will see this is correct. Whatever Lord Krishna has given knowledge to Arjuna, same knowledge we are getting from Dada. Lord Mahavir has given knowledge to Gautam Swami, same knowledge we are getting here from Dada. Whatever Vedanta is explaining, we are getting from Dada. But without this understanding, if you read Vedanta and Jainism, you feel, oh, whatever Jainism says, this is not correct, this Vedanta is correct. Or Jainism people will say, our Jainism is correct, Vedanta is not correct. Like contradiction take place. So we are getting new technique for understanding of pure soul. And that's why we can understand, oh, all scripture, spiritual scripture in this world, it is correct. But it is, somebody is from Chennai to Bombay, Chennai to Ahmedabad, Delhi to Ahmedabad, but we are now at Calcutta. So Calcutta to Ahmedabad, this path is totally different. And Dada Bhagwan has given that new concept for reaching to soul.